What's up, guys? It's me, Urukai. So today is Thursday and the biggest updates came out. First of all, I finally reached 100k power with main team. And well, let's see the updates for survival. Now you can do level up survival. It's the easiest. You can do like 1S and 2S, and you can finish all the survivals and claim all the rewards, so it became very easier. And after you do elite, you can refresh and do the ultimate. Elite one gives you access to ultimate, but I didn't know, so I missed today the ultimate. Also, new power ups game, Mount Mobuku. Here you can upgrade some stats, and you can get obtain these resources in a daily active event pack. So it's 4.0 update claiming pack and claiming things. So after you will do all the some of these activities points, it will give you this. So as you see, the last one, Mount Mobuku gift 3, so it will give you 3 upgrade, also purification rune and refine rune. Some group, it gives a lot of XP though, it's really nice for XPs. Also, what all said it. Also, there is. Oh, here nothing changed, but I hope there will be soon this one when Naruto pack is, you buy for 600 ingots, you are claiming 100 coupons a day. That one is better. I thought this would refresh, but nah. Also, this is nice, you are gaining 10 coupons a day for bonus. I don't know which ninja will be next week, so I'm sorry, next month. Oh, it changes color. What else we have here? Well, let's see the events. So on dice, it's still nice, and it's good that the price didn't change, still cost 20 coupons. And Unbull fragments came again. I want this so much, but last week I got some Maria's eye fragments, so I need coupons to get it. So here we get Kisame, so if you are recharging ingots, you can get some free Kisame frags or data. I think Kisame is better. Or, well, if you're free to play, you can always claim charms or unbound runes. I'm going for unbound runes, it gives nice power. Well, here you can buy Mount Mobuku gift too. I didn't know. Okay, they did. Oh, and Haku. I need some frags of Haku, and I will get him too. He's nice ninja, but not too OP, but really nice one. Again, we are getting A for recharging. They don't get that, we don't need it. We need at least a new A. Lucky Snatch, it's really nice. Today one of in online got 30 fragments of Asuma Blade. None of them got Maskman, but it's on the first day. My team groupmate got 2 times this prize, or 3 times, so it's really OP. And KVKs and charms are nice. Refine fragments came today, refine event. So is rebate and charms, so I got 300 charms activated and I got like 2k power. It's really OP. It was my bet, I could save 15, but I could not hold for next time. What else? This is past week's event, so it's ended, I think. Yeah, here's 50 fragments of Naruto if you want. You will draw and maybe you will have a chance to get Mask Mentor. So now let's see one of the biggest changes in mains. First, this one causes tag and paralyzed as usual, but if the opponent unit already suffering from tag, it has no cooldown, so this one changed from like no more chakra needs. And this is the best one for Tenda, as they change, so now it recovers from 8 to 16% life and 20 chakra as well, and it will cancel all debuffs and will become immune to all debuffs. So Gakido, no need for Gakido to use the shield on this one, you can use Gakido on Tenda, so you have two immunes in your team, so you have safe Tendos. It's pretty nice. I don't know what are they is doing, like Midnight Blood will mark as Anbu. There are some Watermain marked as some Senjutsu user and so on. So it's clone change, you have now two lightning clones. It's really nice. Oh, not big help, but still good for a person. I think no one is using this one. Attack and music increase every unit dies. Oh, this is pretty much cool. Like, yeah, it kills one as it would, but there's a chance of healing two units, so it's pretty damn nice instead of one. And now we can, this one requires 30 chakra and increase ninjutsu, so no more healing, but increase ninjutsu 50% and triggers 2 times. It's pretty nice, it will give nice damage if you're going for attack water main, not healer. And this clone now gives 30 chakra and it's strong clone, 60%. I think it's strongest from them. And this one, course mark, so it, the unit's missile cooldown time is reduced by 1. This is pretty damn nice. It's like cause damage to itself, like Kabuto's thing. I have to test this, it looks pretty nice. So now reduced by 1 is nice. Like, there was one water main using shark and it did in first round his mystery, so it's pretty damn nice. So now recovers 3% of life. So this one caused 2 opponents as it was, but if there is clone, the mystery time will reduce by 1, so it's nice. I think you can use this on every round if you have clone. And also this. But I have to check this. I think you can use it in the first round too, yes. If you just tell me. So this one, well, no one using this anymore. Most of our fire mains use shield. So it had 3 round cooldown, so now it will have 1 round, 2 round if we have clone, and this is pretty nice. So this skill will never miss, and it's same, but it will never miss. And now the low floated cause ripples and imprison, so this is pretty damn cool passive. Chase, I mean. And now you will imprison your enemy. And so if you have clone, your fire main hits twice now. So if you have this one, it will do 20 combo. If you have King of Hell, it will hit like 20 times, then King of Hell. And if you have Orshi, you almost will get 30 hit combo. So it's pretty damn nice. And fire main does tag too. The random opponents will suffer from tag. Hotels. So now blind blinds 2 enemies. Repulse, repulse unit comes. 2 breathers. Only this change, so cooldown will be reduced by 1 round. So it will be like you use first round. Maybe you will use in first round. I don't know. Or in second round, third round, and then it will be in 2 rounds, not in 3. I don't know. So now it generates 2 clones instead of 1. There's chance. This is nice too, it triggers twice now. Ripples knockdown. So with Reno it's cool. And this guy's blindness. And with this you have extra standard attack, so they're pretty much nice chases which you will get. They're all nice. And also this is this change, like will be immune to debuffs and have a shield generated by 40% of units resistance, so it lasts for 2 rounds. It's pretty much like light mains immune to debuffs and will have shield plus. So 40% shield and immune to debuffs. And another round of female. So only 2, like you and your female unit. So if you have Orshi, Wind main, and some female like Sailor Sakura, it's pretty nice. It will shield. What else? I remember every time a unit. Chakra Thunder will also recover 12%. Okay. 3 shadow clones with life base 20% of main body. So our cable is in Taijutsu and low float. Okay, some standard attack. There was a 15 chair and decrease the unit's ninjutsu 6%. Well, this is pretty nice. Every time this triggers chase skill. This skill, Breeze Dancer, will be marked as Senjutsu user. I don't know what this means. So Earth main is pretty damn nice now. With this you have now 30% to 4 opponents, to all of your ninjas. It will generate 30% of shield. And with this one it's pretty nice. You can get now 60 chakra instead of 40 chakra. If you have in the same line ninjas, I tried it and it works pretty damn nice. Like, it gives shields to 3 of them, like pretty nice shield, and I will have 60 chakra. So next round I will use QB as usually. And on third round when I will have this again, I can use Kara with no problem. It's pretty damn nice. So this gives 10% shield now instead of 20, but there's a chance to give 20%. So if there is like you're surrounded by shield, it will do same low floating immobile, and this is pretty nice. Like at the beginning of battle, generates a 40% shield instead of 50, but it gives 9 units in your field. So great ninja war, it's pretty nice if they don't have Han against you. It's really nice. And now it's got nerfed, like no more 100% defense, but it will give, it will increase defense and resistance in low health recall. And this is then nerfed by 20% resistance, but the biggest one is this. If you have melee units, you will have combo rate by 40% and attack increase by 20%. So you have plus 80% attack with male characters, like 80%, and combo plus like 160%. So Earth main is still pretty damn nice. I was light main and I switched to Earth main to get this. And some changes in skills. Normal Kara. No one used normal Kara, but shields on its attack based on 30% of resistance. And 20, so all units get 20% of shield at the beginning of battle. And this is pretty nice one. So Jiraiya now reduced 10% of resistance, and Tsunade is pretty nice now. It will recover life based on 80% of ninjutsu based attribute and will cancel all debuffs, so it's pretty nice. And it attacks twice. Orochimaru, no one is using it, but it gives ninjutsu and 10% attack and 40% instead of healing and chakra. And Minato is pretty damn nice now. So now his mystery interrupts, tags, knockdown. And if there is tag, it can hit up to 9 opponent units of tag. So if you have like hidden, it will, they both will attack pretty much nice damage. So now, before ejection, he attacks some random guy and also attack increased by 9% and combo by 12%, so he is pretty damn nice. And now instead of Konoha, there's no units in your team by 4%. So no more combo rate because you have combo rate here. If the opponent field has a unit tag, under tag, the affected unit will suffer high float. This is the affected unit no longer be under tag. No, the hell with this. Under tag, the affected unit will suffer high float. Tag. Okay. I think it's same. Oh, here is some added classified Uzumaki, Karsmark type, there is blood limit and hidden mist type. So that's all for now, guys. Thanks for watching. I think that's all. It didn't change here, nothing new. Only this one, what we checked. Events. If you have some coupon stuff, I would suggest to go for Ambu outfit because it is like from 1 to 2k power, I think. And then go for charms or refines. They're both good. So that's pretty much done for today. Okay, thanks for watching and see ya guys. Bye bye.